He's from where?
But I think they handle, you know, Brendan handles Washingtonville, Blooming Grove, and Chuck Hagan.
Could be here from Christmas.
Well, this we budgeted.
Yeah.
We budgeted this under just the A fund.
Right to Florida, it was coming out of that grant.
No, that was different.
Pay us back, I thought, right? Wasn't that pay us back? That's when we budgeted it.
Yeah, I don't think there's, the funds are a separate line item. We have a different line item just for funds. That was a part of the grant.
Looking at the.
Just going through a 100-foot buffer of the TDC wetland?
Yeah. Looking at the fund.
Yeah.
Yeah, the one that was now.
Yeah.
Was half of it.
I know my pool has one half of it. This is a little bit less than that.
Right.
But it does say 20 feet.
Exactly.
In height, 20, 30 feet.
I mean, it's how big we want it. Some, a lot of the companies I contacted even always suggested half a horsepower, but they only think 10 to 15. And I think that was kind of low. So you can go bigger. I just priced out the one horsepower. And if you look at the width lights, so the one horsepower floating pump, six different patterns you can make it do, you know, as far as the spray pattern you want. Of white lights, and if you look at the last page, it's the quote, which I thought was phenomenal for that size pump and all and the lights. And the other companies I checked with are twice that much.
Yeah, I had looked at Lasco, through Devitts, and it was like 5,000.
Right.
But I think it was a 5 horsepower.
That's big, 5 horsepower.
I believe that's what it was.
That's maybe like 100 foot of water.
Well, how deep are those pumps?
That's the other issue.
Where's Costa Rica?
The bigger you go, the deeper you need.
Yeah.
So really one horsepower, so you don't want to max it more than that, because then you're going to be like 10 feet down to suck the water out. And it might not be 10 feet deep.
Well, this is obviously better than $5,000.
So if we get the approvals, if we have a budget in there, we can get our breakdown, and we can do the one coming off of the well, have some water, and have at least one in.
But I'd like to think that we're going to just keep moving, we can start it, and we'll move it together. Not to just put one in, and one in.
Oh, no, no, I agree, but I'm saying this.
I believe John.
Both of you.
Right, O&R might never get back to us. Okay, so at that point, then, if we do go to the large pond,
right.
We do take it off Newcastle.
We don't need O&R at the Memorial Pond.
No, we don't, we just go right off the wellhouse.
If we came off of Newcastle, we went to Boston, we don't need a meter.
Yeah. Would they be there for a meter?
You would have to put a meter.
We'd have to put a meter.
Well, can't go like your street lights.
Not
a meter.
For Newcastle, but not for.
I think both.
There's a meter there.
We can come off the meter at.
At the pond, yeah, okay. So it's just one.
Use the meter that's there already.
And I suggested. Circuit board, everything, we just tap right in off of that. We just need, there wasn't enough openings, right?
I mean, we can make it work, there's no reason why we can't.
Right.
Good.
But I suggested to, that we put the controls inside the wellhouse.
Yes.
We don't put the controls on the outside, because it's obvious, you see the vandalism that's going on over there with the fence, and, you know, I could see the graffiti all over the meter, you know. So if you want it inside the wellhouse, you have more control over it than anything else. It's just a suggestion.
Let's see, this guy gets back to you tomorrow, latest Wednesday, from O&R. And then he might say, it's a great idea, we can't do it until February. Thank you.
Right, but that's for the other pond.
Yeah.
Yeah, but for this one, we can set it up and start working on it.
Yep.
Could you deal with that? I'll talk to you then.
What's that?
We'll talk to you about getting it going.
Yeah. Like I say, you need to give me the specs and everything else, to see what we need for power-wise for it, and go from there.
You know, it's not on the agenda, but talking about
Just before you get to, so everybody approved moving forward with the first one?
Yes.
Take a vote.
Well, it's a budgeted item.
I understand, but you're still making an expenditure on this particular quote.
So roll call. Trustee Kolar?
Yes.
Trustee Mack?
Yes.
Deputy Mayor Lang?
Yes.
Trustee McDowell?
Yes.
Yes, so 5-0. So Friday we should be getting back. Talking about the security, I met another contractor out at Memorial Park regarding putting up cameras with a monitor in the police station, because there's something, we have something in the park that has to be monitored. You have the law on that, or?
In terms of?
We just can't put a camera and say it's being monitored.
No.
So.
Means to be in the, yeah.
So we have to have another monitor put in the police station. We need a bigger police station for the monitors that we have.
Or it can't feed into one of the existing monitors and the burn tank?
I don't know.
You have to speak to the company about that.
I took him down to Vern Allen, okay, for cameras down there. And we still have to address the cameras at
Woodfield.
Okay. Cameras were installed at Woodfield concession stand / storage building, a former or future well house for us. We don't have any access to those cameras. We did not install them. I believe they were donated by somebody literally.
Where are the monitors for those?
I don't know.
They probably are not.
Well, I know, it's similar to what you see here in this room, placed on the eaves. I don't know if it's all the way around the building.
So they're just self-recording and?
I guess, but.
You say we don't have access to that?
We don't have access to that.
Who does?
I don't know.
Absolutely.
They might just be glued up on the eave, I don't know. There's wires.
Or the TV camera, or TV and recording VCR and concession stand. I have access to that.
You have access to it? Okay.
Literally put up the cameras.
Just the VCR?
Does it have,
it's a data system.
I haven't been in a while, so I don't know.
It's monitored by a private company.
It's a village acquired one.
So what do we need to do on this to straighten it out? Yeah, you can speak to them in session. Just to say, why did you do it, or?
Anybody move it? This is an ethical session.
It's an ethical session.
Are they able to use something in session?
No.
It's ours.
Unless we're in control.
Correct.
Sure.
So we have to have.
Or turn over access to the village if you want to keep it.
You want to prepare paperwork for that?
Back to, when we talk about the security, Memorial Park, the gentleman suggested a second camera for the monuments for where?
There's two red maples. Well, he wanted to put it in the middle of the field, which I don't know what he was thinking. But there's two red maples on a pole, okay, that would blend within the tree line to shoot towards the monument.
I walked it. He had a good idea.
What about where you got your electrical panel? Right, where we got the electric service coming in? one part of it.
We could, yeah, another one could be there, one on the building.
We probably, and it would be hidden, you know, people would not know that it's a camera, no, it's part of the.
Well, I don't.
You know, instead of just trying to pop them up in the tree, you know.
Well, it's not gonna be higher than the tree. People need to know that there's cameras there.
Oh, yeah, you have to, you have to say that.
You're being recorded.
Yeah.
And that's under the security law. But there's an idea that where you have a power source there already at the meter.
Yeah, that's, you know, he was more or less telling us, it was Leslie Leaf. Then he came to this building, which is another story. But a second camera, one camera's not going to do it. So one on the building and then one on where he suggested, but I don't even think we spoke about what you just mentioned, where the panel is. Dana Vern Allen, one on the building. And then a, more or less a camera, but not so expensive, for people that are going into the future dog park. It would be recording after hours, okay? And I'll have some drawings on that, hopefully by the next meeting. It has to be locked, so anyone who is traveling down that path will be recorded. So at that point, they're trespassing. But we also have to come up with signs throughout our parks. When is it open, when is it closed? We do have to close it. Starting with Woodfield, I mean, we have a gate there, it's never closed. Last one out closes the gate on the rounds in the morning, DPW could open the gate.
And I noticed we were sure that that was today, that water issue they have. And it's not the first time I've seen it, people will drive, they have little kids and they go to the playground, they'll drive their car right to the playground along that little path. Instead of parking in the parking lot. So there's gotta be a way we can block that path off. Because they'll drive right there and then they'll turn around on the grass when they're leaving.
Yeah, well, we could do it with Stan at Vern Allen on the, by Green Bower. Talking about that, let's jump back to Memorial Park. That bench is damaged. It could be from kids on skateboards, whatever thing is. Gentleman who, forget his name, came in last week. Maybe, yeah, I don't think it was last week. That we might be able to fix that bench. If not, we have to replace that bench. So I think you were going to look into if there was a fund that was still active. But I think we need to put bollards around the benches so no one's running into them, whether it be even accidental lawnmower running into them to protect it. Because the benches, you know, they mean something. They mean something to a lot of people, and we need to protect them. So that's where we stand on the parks. We've got a lot of work to do.
Regarding Vern Allen Park, are you guys still going to host the carnival there every year with the damage that gets done every year from that carnival? That park is in bad shape.
It is. This year, I think the fact that it was 10 days of rain.
Right.
Okay, and then they decided, hey, we still have to set up the carnival. There was a lot of damage.
Yeah.
It's just a conversation that we all have to have with the Knights of Columbus.
But
it is in their permit.
No, I get that. And they are, you know, I saw them rolling it today, but, you know, whatever repairs they're making, I mean, if you look at it, it's just a mishmash of weeds, and now it just, the whole lawn just looks terrible.
No, you know.
I mean, not that it has to be a Scots lawn or whatever, but it just looks horrible.
But it could be a Scots lawn. And we can't keep fixing something.
Right.
All right, we take one step up, two steps back. So even though it is being fixed, it was fixed last year.
Right.
No one knew that there was a carnival there.
Right, right.
This year they know there was a corner because, and then they put the dumpster on the line, which just I think my head just went boof.
When I first moved there, it used to be at the nice corners.
I think they outgrew it. I think that was the deal. I don't really know.
The cross tonight had Home Depot buckets in the holes where the kids wouldn't go in.
Did they really?
Yeah.
Wow, I didn't see that.
What do we do about pitch wall? I don't remember them getting a curb cross.
They never did get one, man.
Well, they play every Thursday, because they're going to have a week.
I'm going to ask them to come in for facilities.
But I thought it was dangerous because it's not fixed that.
Well, I don't think they're playing on the, they're playing between the cracks as facilities that's out.
Next is where the crack is.
I think it's nicely laid out.
They said they were going to be fixed.
Actually, we're down there.
Not there, no. Stop.
You said, you just said they were going to be fixed.
I think it's Ken Crew that says this. Did I say that right? To come in so that they can say one.
Because when some patient hurts themselves, they're going to have to ask. Because I don't remember sanctioning it.
Good to have a service.